Pakistan frets to face the truth about its terror organizations and activities in Afghanistan. Pakistan's National Security Advisor Mohid Yusuf says that he's not going to be attending the meeting called by India and Afghanistan on the 10th of November. In addition to Pakistan, which was invited for the meeting, China and Russia and Iran, as well as other nations, have been invited as well. So let me go across to Pradeep Datta, who's joining us. Pradeep, they say that those who are actively backing terror today have faced the blowback of that on themselves. Quite understandably, Pakistan does not want to be part of any meeting, any summit, where they themselves stand to be exposed.
Yes, you're absolutely right, because red-faced Pakistan, already the bluff has been caught, and now they are avoiding and shying away from this meeting. They know that they will be further exposed. Even being that just few days back, you know, times we reported how Taliban appointed diplomats were allowed to work in Pakistan embassies, in embassies there in Pakistan and consulates there in Pakistan. So this clearly shows that they are legitimizing diplomatically Taliban, and they are without recognizing them in front of the world. And Pakistan had been exposed many a time for their complicity with Taliban regime, how they had been supporting this terror regime from day one. If all these Taliban had been able to survive for the last 20 years, it was because of the backing and support of Pakistan. Otherwise, it would have been difficult for them to survive. Not only that, but they're also allowing the regrouping of the terror. We reported that how after the fall of Afghanistan, we saw that ISI chief Faiz Hamid was there for many a days. He was trying to share political discourse and all, take action against all those Panjshir fighters in Panjshir Valley. And now they know that they will be completely exposed, because the world has come to know. It is basically the Pakistan epicenter of terror.
Pakistan's even given visas to legitimize the Taliban rule to the terrorists who are now running Afghanistan. Understandably, they can make lame excuses. They don't want to attend the summit because it's in India. But we all know what the real reason is. Thank you so much, Pradeep Datta, for joining us.